This Pity, She is a Whore by John Ford. Characters, Summary, Analysis. Hello and welcome to The Discourse. John Ford was an English playwright during the Jacobean and Caroline age of English literature. John Ford was born in 1586 and he died in 1639. He collaborated with Thomas Dacre, John Webster, William Rowley, Philip Massinger and others during the Jacobean era and emerged as an influential and successful playwright during the Caroline age. John Ford is a noteworthy playwright because of the subject of his dramas, which often remained the conflict between individual passion and conscience and the morals and laws of society. His characters often expressed strong abnormal psychology. John Ford was highly influenced by Robert Burton's work, The Anatomy of Melancholy, published in 1621. Many of his dramas were influenced by the matter of this book. One such Ford's play was This Pity, She is a Whore, which is a tragedy and was first performed in 1629. This play has a very unusual subject. It talks about an incestuous relationship between a talented brother and his beautiful sister. Despite such a controversial subject, the play was very much liked by people. John Ford doesn't depict the brother as some villain. Rather, he presents him as the tragic hero, a talented, virtuous and noble man who is overcome by a tumultuous, unavoidable passion that led him to his destruction. Characters of This Pity, She is a Whore. Giovanni is a young scholar who returned from university. He is the son of Florio. Annabella is the daughter of Florio, sister of Giovanni. Friar Bonaventura is a friendly priest who appreciates Giovanni's talent and tries to help him come over his immoral passion. Bagatto, Grimaldi and Sorrenjo are the suitors of Annabella. She initially rejects all of them but ultimately decides to marry Sorrenjo. Donato is Bagatto's uncle. Ricciardetto is an Italian soldier, husband of Hippolyta, the former lover of Sorrenjo. Philotis is a niece of Ricciardetto who marries Bagatto. Putana is the tutress of Annabella who encourages her to get involved in the immoral affair with Giovanni. Vasc is a loyal servant to Sorrenjo. Poggio is a servant of Bagatto and the banditti is a gang of outlaws. Summary of This Pity, That She is a Whore. The play is set in Parma, an Italian city, and it has one main plot and two subplots. The main plot is about Giovanni and Annabella. Giovanni is a talented scholar who returned from his university to live with his father Florio and sister Annabella. The play begins with a philosophical debate between Friar Bonaventura and Giovanni. Giovanni argues that love between siblings is prohibited because of old customs that should be rejected. Friar understands that Giovanni is facing an ethical dilemma regarding his sister Annabella. He tells him that such thoughts are evil and he must repent. Giovanni tries to repent and shed off such feelings, but his passion for Annabella is too strong. Annabella is unaware of her brother's feelings. Bagatto, Grimaldi and Sorrenjo are her suitors. Her father Florio is worried about her marriage. When Giovanni talks with her, she says that she is not interested in any of the three suitors. Giovanni reveals her feelings for her. Annabella is shocked after knowing her brother's feelings. When she discusses the issue with her tutress Putana, she encourages her to support Giovanni's feelings. Finally, Annabella falls for Giovanni's passion and the brother and sister consummate their relationship in secrecy. The other plot is about a young soldier Ricciardetto, his wife Hippolyta and Sorrenjo, one of the Annabella's suitors. Vasc is Sorrenjo's loyal servant. Sorrenjo gets involved in extramarital behavior with Ricciardetto's wife. Hippolyta and Sorrenjo plan to send Ricciardetto on such a battlefront where his death is imminent so that they can marry after his death. However, Sorrenjo gets interested in Annabella and he breaks his relationship and vows with Hippolyta. Ricciardetto survives the battle and returns to Parma in disguise to take revenge against Sorrenjo. He is living with his niece Philotis. Grimaldi and Sorrenjo fight for Annabella's hand and Vasc, being a loyal servant, challenges Grimaldi for a sword's fight. Ricciardetto encourages Grimaldi and says that to win Annabella, he will need to stab and kill Sorrenjo. Meanwhile, Bagatto meets Philotis and decides that instead of Annabella, he will marry Philotis. Both get betrothed. Poggio is Bagatto's servant. Ricciardetto encourages Grimaldi to kill Sorrenjo and tells him to wait for Sorrenjo at a secluded place where he will bring Sorrenjo so that Grimaldi may murder him. However, it is the same place where Philotis and Bagatto plan to get married secretly. In a confusion, Grimaldi stabs Borghetto and kills him. Philotas, Donato, and Poggio are too disturbed by this accidental murder. On the other hand, Annabella and Giovanni continue their immoral affair and Annabella gets pregnant. She confesses to Friar Bonaventura and he persuades her to marry Sorrangio so that her ignominious relationship with Giovanni may not be revealed. When Hippolyta comes to know about Sorrangio's marriage, she gets too upset and seeks Vasque's help in taking revenge against Sorrangio. On the wedding night, Hippolyta visits the marriage party and says that she wants to have a toast with Sorrangio to celebrate his marriage with Annabella. When they take their drink, Hippolyta says that she came to take revenge and she has poisoned Sorrangio's drink. Vasque then says that he was always loyal towards Sorrangio and changes his glass of drink with that of Hippolyta. Hippolyta starts feeling the effects of poison. She dies while cursing Sorrangio and Vasque. Ricciardetto was also present there in disguise. He realizes that revenge is always harmful and decides to abandon his plan to take revenge against Sorrangio. He sends Philotas to a convent. After marriage, Sorrangio discovers that Annabella is already pregnant. They argue over it and Annabella realizes that Sorrangio truly loved her. She feels very guilty and decides to repent. Sorrangio plots with Vasque to take revenge against Annabella and Giovanni. Vasque tells him to take the help of goons of the banditti gang. To know more about Giovanni and Annabella's relationship, Vasque makes friend with Putana, who reveals that Annabella was not interested in that relationship, but she encouraged her to sleep with Giovanni. Vasque feels that Putana was a major reason for this immodest relationship and he orders the bandits to tie her up and take both of her eyes out. Sorrangio and Vasque then plan to arrange a feast during which they will take revenge against Giovanni. Annabella hears their plan and writes a letter to Giovanni to warn him and persuade him not to attend the feast. She sends that letter to Giovanni through Friar Bonaventura. The friar meets Giovanni and tries to persuade Giovanni not to visit the feast. When Giovanni comes to know that Sorrangio came to know about Annabella's pregnancy before marriage, he realizes that Annabella is in jeopardy. He decides to take revenge against Sorrangio. On the day of the feast, Giovanni visits Sorrangio's house and enters Annabella's room. They share their troubles and then Giovanni stabs Annabella to die so that she may not face the ignominy of giving birth to her brother's child. He says that he hopes to meet Annabella in the afterlife where they can live with love and peace. He carves Annabella's heart out and skews it on his long knife and takes it out to the feast place. He confesses his love affair with Annabella in front of all the visitors. When Florio hears all this, he feels very shocked and sad and dies of a broken heart. Giovanni then attacks Sorrangio and lethally injures him. Vasque comes to help Sorrangio and he attacks Giovanni while shouting revenge. The man of banditti gang come and attack Giovanni and kill him. Sorrangio dies peacefully as his revenge against Giovanni is fulfilled. Giovanni also dies peacefully as he took revenge against Sorrangio. When the cardinal investigates the massacre, he comes to know about the relationship between Giovanni and Annabella. He asks if there is anybody who knows about it. Vasque informs him that Putana knows and tells him how she encouraged the siblings. The cardinal orders banishment of Vasque and he becomes an outlaw. The cardinal finds Putana's crime too grave and orders her to be burnt off the stake. Ricciardetto was also present in the feast in his disguise. He reveals his true identity to Donato and soothes him for his nephew's Borghetto's death. And the play ends as the cardinal says about Annabella, who could not say, 'Tis pity she is a whore. John Ford often raised such controversial issues of passion and morals in his plays. In this play, he presents Giovanni and Annabella in such a manner that the audience may feel sympathy towards them. His other play, The Lover's Melancholy, was also inspired by Robert Burton's Anatomy of Melancholy. So this is it for today. We will discuss some more important plays and playwrights of the Jacobean and Caroline era. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.